now. First, though, more from the Caribbean islands. And because Turks and Caicos is getting hit right now, communications are difficult. Just before airtime, I spoke with the local governor, John Freeman. Governor, what are the conditions like right now at Turks and Caicos?
Well, it partly depends which part of Turks and Caicos you're in, actually, Anderson. I'm in Providenciales, the biggest island in terms of population, and the hurricane winds are upon us this minute or two. We've had tropical winds before that. Other parts of the islands, Grand Turk was the first to hit, and the eastern part of the islands has been having hurricane winds for some time, and there's quite a lot of damage on that island already. At least 15 roofs have come off, and there's damage to part of the roof of the hospital.
Are many of the buildings in the islands, are they prepared in terms of how they're constructed for this? Obviously, hurricanes are something that have happened before, but nothing this size.
Yeah. The answer is it varies. I mean, the more recently built, yes, because they meet contemporary standards of hurricane proofing. The older the buildings are, the more vulnerable they often are. People, of course, do try to improve them and renovate them and make them stronger. And there's been quite a deal of preparation by people to secure their houses and where they're not securable to leave the house and to go to the shelters which the government is providing.
Do you know at what time it's expected to be at its worst?
Well, again, it depends from island to island, but for this island of Providenciales, the worst time is between, well, now, 7 o'clock and 2:30 in the morning, our time.
And have people evacuated? Are there shelters for people to go to?
There are. We put out evacuation orders on two islands on Tuesday and Wednesday, where there's a small population. And others in low-lying areas where there's a high risk of inundation, they've been encouraged to either go to other family or friends higher up on the island or to go into the government-supplied shelters, which are open and are now getting pretty full.
Do you have any sense of how many people are in government-supplied shelters?
I don't know the exact number, I'm afraid, off the top of my head. But, I mean, for example, in Grand Turk, where there are two shelters operating, the figure must be of the order of 300.
A national shutdown, I understand, was declared today in the Turks and Caicos, freezing emergency services until the storm has passed. That's obviously a common move in many places because it can be just too dangerous for emergency personnel to go out during the storm. Is the message to people now just stay where you are?
Yes, it is. It's hunker down. Stay where you are. Because you can't go out because the winds are just far, far too strong. Nobody can get to you either. So, you know, people are to that extent for a little while on their own or with their families or in the shelters. We took some steps before the storms came, of course, not only in terms of the shelters, but, for example, I was yesterday visiting hospitals, and so we brought in women who are pregnant and at risk of having a confinement over these 3 days. We brought in all of those who needed to have dialysis, which only lasts for 3 days, so they were in from 4:30 in the morning all day having that dialysis done. So some things have been done to prepare as best we can, even against those kind of medical emergency-like things.
And just in terms of supplies of gas, of petrol, of water, of food, how are things?
Well, water production, the pumping, goes down, of course, with the electricity. So in Grand Turk, which, as I say, is the first island hit, water pumping went down quite early because the electricity went down quite early. But people have stocked up a lot on water. I mean, just as you've seen it in queues in Florida and elsewhere, people have been collecting water. People here have been used to hurricanes, as you said earlier, and so they collect water, you know, just to drink and for other purposes, too.
Well, Governor Freeman, we wish you the best in the hours ahead. Thank you.
Thank you very much for your time.